Hi guys, one more video about NVIDIA drivers and Linux Mint and Ubuntu. In the previous video we saw how to install the latest recommended driver and how to deal with some typical problems. Finally we saw some very useful commands when you have problems related to video and audio for Linux Mint and Ubuntu. And in this video we can see some other problems and how to fix them in more details. So first let's start with a typical situation for Linux Mint. You have two drivers or more. You have a recommended one which should be in use, and also you have Xserver Novell which is installed by default on most systems. On the other hand, let's see a fresh installation for Linux Mint without any driver. In order to detect do you have drivers or not on your system, for NVIDIA you can use a command like NVIDIA.sme, and this command could have several different outputs. If you have command NVIDIA not found but can be installed with, this means that you don't have any NVIDIA driver installed for your system and you need to install one. How to install? You can get a command like Ubuntu drivers auto-install and use this command, or on the other hand you can use install with a given driver. So let's start and check what is going to happen with Ubuntu drivers auto-install, and then let's see what is going to happen with the install NVIDIA driver 390, which is the recommended one. As you can see right now we don't have any available drivers for automatic installation, and we can install a given one with this install. This is going to add the driver to the system, and sometimes you can get output like this: NVIDIA.sme has failed because it couldn't communicate with the NVIDIA driver. This means that your driver is broken and you can follow some steps in order to fix it. If the driver is installed correctly, you can check an output like this one. So let me use again the NVIDIA.sme, and you can get the driver version, some information about the GPU and the processes which are using it. And if the driver is broken, which can be broken because of the some problems related to update of the drivers itself, or they can be broken because of a kernel update, then you need to follow some recovery steps, and these steps are written in the article here. You can see them. First you can go and find what is the kernel that you have and do you have a change in the kernel with command uname -r, and you can see that I have 4.15.46, and on this system we can check that we have 4.15.20, and after update to 46 I had a good NVIDIA driver, but my system was broken and I wasn't able to use the system normally. The system enter in a software rendering mode. After that I had some black screens and even I had some problems with logging into my Linux Mint. And let's check, you can skip this or you can do it. We saw already the output for it. How to recover your driver? You can try with using the following commands, for example apt-get-f-install if you have incomplete installation. You can try to use command with install aptitude and aptitude install the given package, which could fix the problem in some situations. And finally you can try to install with argument reinstall the given driver, and if this is not working and you still get software rendering mode or Novell driver is loaded instead of your NVIDIA and you have a black screen, then you need to follow different steps, and these steps are described here. So you need to lock in console mode with Control Alt F1. This can be restored with Control Alt F7. So you're going to change the console mode with a graphical mode. Once you're in console mode, you can stop the X server by using sudo service ytdm stop or start for starting it. Then you can purge all your drivers using this command or using these two commands. Normally they would do similar things. And finally you can identify, do you have some extra packages, for example NVIDIA 396, and remove them because they could lead to some problems as we saw in the previous video. Once this is done, you can install a driver which is already downloaded on your system, or you can install the driver using the previous command with sudo install and the name of the driver. And finally, I wanted to mention that also you can hold a given driver to not be updated for your system by using sudo apt mark hold the given NVIDIA driver, and this can be restored by using unhold. You can see also that by mistake you can enter in a software rendering mode for your Linux Mint Cinnamon. So let's start. This is going to hold your drivers. Once they are installed, if you have this package here, we need to have driver and 390. And you can see that now this driver is set on hold and this driver is not going to be updated further. But you have subversion updates like this one here, which means that you have the recommended one, but with some subversion in it. Let's see how you can enter in console mode for this system. So right now we are in this Linux here. You need to press Ctrl Alt F1. Now you are going to be asked for your user, then a password. Now you're in this machine and you need to stop the X server. This can be done by using sudo service lightdm stop. And now you're going to be asked for a password. And by the way, you can change this behavior for stars for your passwords in Linux Mint by removing a given line in one file. You can check a video from this playlist if you want. Now the X server is stopped and you need to purge the NVIDIA drivers. This can be done by this I don't have the command here. So in general you can use sudo apt purge nvidia and for example asterisk, and this should remove all the things related to nvidia. And now the driver should be completely removed from your system and you can reinstall it. And this should fix the problem related to broken driver due to update for the driver or also for the kernels. Let's go back to the article. So in this article you can find all the information which is needed for these steps and some typical problems. In my opinion, you need to identify first what is the problem for you, then to find how you can fix it, and finally to get this article somewhere or the steps which are working for you and try to do them next time your driver is broken. In my opinion also, you can try to do the easiest ways to reinstall the driver by using commands like this, and if this is fixing the problem, then oh, it's okay for you. And also I wanted to say that if you have any problems related to NVIDIA drivers and Linux Mint, you can post a command below and I will try to fix this problem in another video. If you like this video, please put a like, and also if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe for the channel. Thank you for watching and see you next time.